Hi, my name is Ryan Kliethermes with KE2 Therm Solutions. In this video, I want to show you some of the information that's available from the settings page of the KE2 Evaporator Efficiency controller. While this video will specifically show the KE2 Evap webpage, all of our Ethernet-enabled controllers like the KE2 Evap for rack efficiency and controlled environment provide similar ability to control and communicate. Okay. So you were on the home page and selected the settings button found on the bottom of the page. At the top of the settings page, the customer information as well as the IP and MAC addresses and the location description are displayed, the same as we saw on the home page review. To make changes to any of the web pages, you must go to the login button in the lower right corner, then enter your login information. The default for firmware versions after 3.0 are KE2 Admin and KE2 Admin. Then click Submit in the lower right corner. You'll now be back on the settings page and ready to make changes if needed. Taking a look at the upper left of the page, we find location settings. This is where you can add the business name, phone number of the contractor, and the location of the controller. Below this section is the alert notifications box. When the controller indicates an alarm is present, an alert will be sent via email or text message to the person you designate. It is not uncommon for customers to tell us the alerts have helped them save a freezer full of food, so be sure to take advantage of this benefit. Below this is the webpage login. For security reasons, it is a good idea to change to a new username and password from the factory defaults. And the last box on the left is the API box. This is required when integrating the controller into existing building or energy management systems. Okay, so let's move to the middle of the page. At the top, to the site view option box. Site view is an advanced feature used to set a local dashboard of multiple controllers that is covered in a separate video. Below this, we find the Smart Access Settings section. KE2 Smart Access is one of the newest features of the KE2 Evaporator Efficiency Controller. If KE2 Smart Access is enabled, the controller can easily be accessed from the KE2 Smart Access portal site that you create. For additional information on the benefits of KE2 Smart Access, please check out our website. The final column on the far right of the page starts with the firmware information. This provides the current version of the firmware found on the controller as well as a button to update the controller to the latest version of the firmware, which is available from the KE2 Therm website. The controller reset button provides a simple way to cycle power to the controller. This is typically not required, but may be used as part of a diagnostic check sequence. In the logs box, there is a clear button. This will remove the 31-day data log stored on the controller. In normal operation, this would not be utilized unless there's a desire to remove historical data. The alarms box with the clear button resets the controller alarms. While this will postpone some alarms for up to 60 minutes, if not corrected, sensor failures will begin alarming again immediately. After you have made any changes, you need to go down to the bottom of the page and select the save button to finalize your changes. So, there you have a general overview of the settings page of the KE2 Evaporator Efficiency Controller, and you can more fully appreciate the way the pages can be used to make managing your refrigeration system easier. We encourage you to view our videos that look at the KE2 Evap's other web pages. For more information, please visit our website or contact our tech support line.